Simply, in this video what we are going to make is this logo. This is very simple logo. We have to first create one rectangle and give all four sides 1% curve, 1 inch curve. Now that's done. And what you have to do is you have to create a circle. Create a circle. Use the ellipse. Fill the color white. No, let it be some other color. Right now, what we are going to do is use the pick tool. Increase the size a bit. Now that's done. Now what you have to do is select the circle as well as the rectangle and back minus front. What it does is it removes the front object from the back object. Select the circle, select the rectangle and the back minus front. Now that's done. You can see. And again the same way we need this gap. What we have to do is create a small rectangle and then use the pick tool, select the rectangle, small rectangle and the big rectangle, and the same way back minus front. Control D, duplicate it. The same way apply here. Select these two and this one. Select the front part and the back rectangle, back minus front. That's done. Select the front part as well as the back part, back minus front. That's done. Now it's time for the letter. Use the rectangle again. Remove the 1 degree curve. Then decrease the size, shift, use the shape tool, slightly curve it, make them fix, zoom in. That is not needed. Now what you have to do is use a pick tool, just rotate it and place it over the original square. I use a shape tool. We are using the shape tool right now. Shape, pick. We made a mistake. What you have to do is we just have to convert into curves and then use the shape tool. Adjust it. This is what our mistake was. Now that's done. Now it's time for the pen tool. Use a pen tool. You'll find it somewhere here. This is a pen tool. Click the first dot, second dot, a third dot, the fourth dot, the fifth dot, the sixth, seventh, and combine all these. Almost done. We don't need anything. Now group these two objects. This one as well as this one, right click it, group object, separate it. Before ungroup it, select this one, select the first curve, the second curve and weld it. You'll see the gap will disappear. That's the reason why we are welding it. and that's done. Now it's time for the P, the same process. We need a rectangle. Convert into curves. Right click. Convert to curves. Place them over the P. Just rotate it a bit. And now use the size tool and size it appropriately. And then use a pen tool. You'll find a pen tool over here. This is the pen tool. First node, second node, third node, fourth node, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10, and join all these. Use a pick tool, zoom in a bit. Convert it. Use the pick tool again, shape tool again. Fix it appropriately. Break curve, convert to curve, drag it outward. Break curve, convert to curve, drag it. Now that's done. Select these two objects, first one, second one, then weld it. You'll see the gap would disappear. Now place them on our square. Use the pick tool, H, P. P size has decreased sometimes, so now that's done. Adjust it. Increase the size. Adjust it. Increase the size. Now we have to use the interactive tool. Select this portion as well as this portion. From dark to light dark. Some dark portion. And this one, the light dark. That looks nice. Use the same interactive tool. Now it's time for the letter. Drag from here to here. Change the color. Use the interactive tool again. Select one node. From here to here, we'll change the color, the dark, and this color. Use the dark violet. It will look nice. that stuff. We made a mistake, that is, we should have done the grouping and then should have changed it. Remove it. What you have to do is group these two, right click, group object. Now use the interactive tool, drag from here, from starting here to ending here. Now it will work fine. Use whichever color is appropriate for you. I'll use this one, and this above portion should have a nice dark color. Now that's done. Thank you for seeing. Meet you in the next logo.